talk about love your neighbor as yourself. Because, wow, nobody ever told me what some aspects of that statement might entail. Let me tell you, wearing a mask is not for the wearer's protection. It's for your neighbor. None of us, none of the people you see driving their cars or shopping in stores, know if any of us are carrying the virus. So be grateful if you're healthy. So why the mask? Well, without a mask, you could, without meaning to, cough or sneeze and be just close enough to infect someone. Now, the worst part of the story is that you would never, ever, ever, ever know that you did it. Our being 6 feet away from people, the non-handshake welcome, the staying home, the closing down places where more than 10 people can meet, and for some of us, the inability to get a hot dog at Stripes, well, that shows examples of how people are loving their fellow neighbors in so many unique ways. But folks, all of this is troubling. The constant downpour of negative and scary information just drags us down, and it tires us out. We can't see the light at the end of the dark tunnel we find ourselves in. Nope. What can we use to lift ourselves up? Well, for myself, I like thinking about small things. Like people's hair and sparrows. You know, like in Luke 12:7, where it says, "And the very hairs on your head are all numbered. So don't be afraid. You are more valuable to God than the whole flock of sparrows." You get the idea? Put your mind on spirit. You probably have your own affirmations and uplifting phrases that you can use when you get down. I'd use them if I were you. I have one more phrase, and again, it deals with something, oh, very, very, very small, and something that we can get our thoughts around when calm thoughts are just hard to find. Now, you can find this version of Matthew 17:20 in the Aramaic Bible in plain English. This is the end of that phrase. "I say to you that if you had faith like the grain of mustard seed, you may say to this mountain, 'Move from here,' and it will move. And nothing will be difficult for you." So remember that. And remember to love your neighbor. Now.